Hi, this is Conor Brady from Dogs First. As you can see from the clip there and a couple of images, Dudley's home. So we're just settling him into the house. So it's the second video in this series of videos about the recovery that we're going to do with Dudley from his spinal operation that he's had. So this video is going to be about getting prepared for your dog to come home. Don't make the same mistake I did, and suddenly your dog comes home and you realise, I've only got half the stuff I actually need. What was I thinking, okay? The reason for it is because I was told on Saturday afternoon that my dog was a little bit sick. I was told on Sunday morning it was an absolute emergency. Monday morning he's in the orthopaedic surgeon. Wednesday morning I'm picking up, and your head is absolutely all over the place. So you're going to be like me, and you're not only going to get half this stuff when it happens, because it happens so fast, you know, you don't know where you are. So here's a list of everything that you should have before your dog comes home, in that day or two or three's grace you have before you pick them up from the surgeon. Pick up these bits. I've divided into six or seven little groups of things you need to think about, okay? The very first one is living area. I'm going to put up a little video now of the dog's living area that I have for Dudley. You've got two things you need to think about. The dog's going to need a pen, and he's going to need a crate, okay? A pen is like, you know, a child's play pen. There's ones for dogs, you can make your own, but anything that secures the dog inside a 2 by 1 meter space, maybe 2 by 2 meter space, if you have that sort of space in your house, to confine him, because we all want him running around the place. Now, initially, for the first 2 or 3 weeks, he's only kind of dragging himself around. And at this point, there is two different lines of thought. Orthopedic surgeons I've spoken to, both of them have said that there is no harm in your dog dragging himself around a little bit. Whereas they would say there is a harm in putting the dog inside a crate, being completely confined, okay, jammed inside a crate. Because what will happen is muscle atrophy. The dog's got to move around, okay? He's got to flex himself and learn how to get around the place. For the first 2 or 3 weeks, it's not a problem, because again, he can't stand and his legs are bad. But I suppose as time goes on, the pen without the top, the dog might be inclined to kind of jump up. We definitely don't want that. So I might have to readdress that down the road. But initially, I'm certainly going with the pen idea. And I'm using the crate in the car only to bring him to his appointments, hydrotherapy, physiotherapy, and the vets and that kind of stuff. Down the road, I might use a crate as well, or I might lower a type of roof onto the playpen so he can't jump up. So a pen and a crate. You must consider the type of flooring you're going to use in the pen, and the dog needs to get a grip on the floor. Okay, so I put a tarpaulin down on the floor first of all, because I don't want any wee on the floor, and then I built the crate, and then I put a camping mat that I got in little for a fiver, and I put that in perfect size for a 2 by 1 meter crate. So that's a nice grippy floor, and it's washable. I bought two of them, and you're going to need to think of kind of an absorbent sieve, you know. So most people would use a bit of newspaper over that, because there's going to be a few wee and poo accidents. I got these dry night absorbent towels that you put on cots for babies. That idea was given to me by Naomi from the Canine Center. She got very upset with me not telling everybody it was her idea last time. So there you go, Naomi. So they're great because you can stick them down to the floor, and when they get soiled you can just tear them up and throw them in the bin. So them or newspapers tend to move around, but once they've been walked on a few times they stay down. So the newspaper will be on top of my camping mat, and Dudley likes blankets. Don't be like me and have maybe 2 dog blankets, 3 dog blankets. You need 6 dog blankets, 7 dog blankets. You're going to go through 1, maybe 2 a day. You want to be able to pick it up and throw it in the washing machine and not think about it. You know you've got another one in the airing cupboard, okay? So have a few blankets ready to go, and his bed goes in the end of the crate. So that's his kind of pen area, safe and dry so your floor doesn't get ruined, and he can drag himself around. And I highly recommend that kind of pen idea. You do need to have that ready to go. The next is cleanliness. Your dog is going to be getting dirty over the next 2 or 3 weeks. He's incontinent, okay? So he's gonna, every time you pick him up, a little bit of wee comes out, or he might have a bit of poo might come out, or, you know, he's like a Pez dispenser sometimes. So you're gonna need to think about cleanliness for the dog, and it's a little bit hairy, kind of, a little bit worrying washing a dog with a big scar on his back. So great product that was given. Another idea from Naomi Tracy, the Canine Center, thanks Naomi, was Magic Foam. Okay, so it's just a foam stuff that you can spray on the dog like that, okay, and you rub it into him and it disappears, okay, when it dries out, and it keeps him clean. So cleaning the back of his feet when you're bringing him for a wee outside, he'll wee on himself a bit, so keep him clean, you know, that's important. Also there's things like pet wipes, you know, can't imagine as much difference between them and human wipes, but awful handy for cleaning up the bits and pieces on the dog. So that helps keep him clean. Also, when you go to hydrotherapy, they wash him before he goes into the pool, and actually when he comes out of the pool, they wash him off as well, which is great. So he comes back to you nice and clean, and they know what they're doing as well. So you're going to be going to hydrotherapy once a week, so he'll get a good bath once a week from them. So for 30 quid, it's not a bad deal. Strongly recommend hydrotherapy. Well, in fact, you have to do hydrotherapy. You really don't have a choice with a spinal dog. The third thing is wound. So your dog's going to have a big wound on his back. There's an image there. I studied his wound, very neat, very dry. I was very surprised. That's Bill McCartney from Noah's Vets in Balderwell. When I got the dog back to seal the wound and make sure it was really, really clean, I used aloe vera. Okay, you don't want to touch it with your fingers. You just crack off an aloe vera leaf. It's just full of goo. I can't kill this plant. This plant has just been around for ages. I just forget about it. Suddenly it's still there. It never complains. But aloe vera is brilliant, so I just squeezed out the goo right along the wound. Okay, aloe vera is an incredible healing plant, brilliant for burns on humans as well, all cuts and grazes. Raw, straight onto the wound, no messing, it heals up like a gum, and it will promote healing really, 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 really quickly. Loads of really good studies behind that, check them out on my website, dogsfirst.ie. The fourth thing is diet. You need to have the diet ready. If you're on Dogs First, I'm a massive promoter of fresh food for dogs, cats and humans and every other animal on the planet. Your dog has to be eating fresh food. There is no alternative, okay? Your dog is sick. He's had a very serious operation. He needs loads of good nutrients to repair the damage. Good Lego to go in there. Dogs are like Lego, okay? Muscle feeds muscle, cartilage feeds cartilage, bone feeds bone. Meat, bone, and organ should be the dominant part of his diet, except when he's recovering from an operation such as a spinal, where his pooing function won't be as strong. I would incorporate a bit more veg in his diet, maybe 20-30% root vegetable, or maybe sweet potato, boiled sweet potato with the skin on, you know, or green beans or spinach or kale. So add fiber to the stool, and it sucks water into the stool and makes an easier poo for the dog who mightn't be able to poo so good. So you have to feed a raw diet. He needs fresh fats, fresh vitamins, fresh calcium. You know, he needs fresh minerals. Everything needs to be fresh going in there. And then there'll be those little things you can do, like the inside membrane of an egg. But I'm going to have a whole video on diet later on. I just wanted to enthuse on you that if you don't know about raw diet now, you need to go to dogsfirst.ie and you need to go to my raw section and read the very first article, which is Tell Me Everything in 10 Minutes. Like, for example, one tiny example, you know, you're feeding your dog fresh meat, cartilage and bone. In that cartilage is loads of glucosamine and chondroitin. Glucosamine and chondroitin are the tablets that everybody puts into their dogs when the dog gets arthritis and poor joints. Maybe if you had been feeding the dog glucosamine and chondroitin from the very start, a natural source of it, you wouldn't need so much to put in the artificial source of it later on. So rather than going out and spending money on glucosamine and chondroitin tablets for pets, buy the ones for humans. They're much cheaper. They're the exact same dosage and everything. I would actually just use cartilage and that kind of thing. Natural additions, okay, your power additions. So the dog's going to be getting loads of things. First of all, he's going to be on buckets of tablets from the vet, and I'm not exaggerating. There's like, this is Dudley's tablets. 1, fiber tablet, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, steroids, antibiotics, things for his gut, things for his back pain, you know, a lot of tablets. Now, granted, when Dudley came home, he I got a bit of a cold and it went into his lungs, so I had to put him on antibiotics for that with Murray, and that's sorted me out with that. So he's on a lot of tablets, okay? And on top of that, I'm giving him some tablets as well. I'm giving him some natural additions that we can put in there. So I do recommend picking up one of these, a tablet organizer, okay? So you don't, I think some tablets are given once a day, some are given twice a day, sometimes you have to give 3/4 of a tablet, that kind of thing. And then you can add in your own things. So like you might be giving the dog milk thistle for his liver, or dandelion root. Joe Arben from holistichound.ie recommends dandelion root and milk thistle, this is the kidneys and the liver, because they're on all these tablets, they need a bit of a help. So, you know, they come in tablet form, you can put them in your pill dispenser too. You might have echinacea, echinacea usually comes in little tiny tablets, you might put a tablet in there as well, you might be on 2 echinacea tablets a day, or more at night. Pill organizer, it's a really, really good idea. So arnica is another great little thing you can get in a natural health store. Arnica comes in little tiny little balls and you can pop them into the food. Brilliant for helping joints. So that will go in your pill organizer as well. Then there is supplements that you can buy and have ready before the dog comes home. So the first supplement I am going to recommend is CBD oil. So anybody now is taking CBD oil because it works for absolutely everything. You might have seen one of my blog posts there 2 months ago on the CBD oil trial I did from Canapet in the US. I got 6 or 7 dogs. The results were incredible. They speak for themselves. Check out that blog post on the Canapet CBD oil trial I did. But it's incredible. It's particularly effective for anxiety. Dog locked in the box is going to have plenty of that. But also for bone regrowth. There was a great study by the University of Tel Aviv which found that in broken bones in rats taking CBD oil, this is from recoverycbd.ie, thank you Neil, the rats taking CBD oil healed 35% faster, and post-mortem those bones were 50% stronger. CBD oil works in so many ways. It's a blog post in itself, and I'm going to blog about it again, but if you want more information about CBD oil, go to my website and check out the article I did on it about 2 weeks ago. But there's going to be more about CBD oil coming in a couple of weeks, because I'm just learning so much from Neil from recoverycbd.ie. The science behind it is phenomenal. It's just incredible. If you can, you get it on his gums. You want it to go into the blood as opposed to into the gut, because we're trying to target inside the dog, blood to the brain. It's anxiety trying to target. If you had a gut issue, Crohn's, IBS type issue, you'd let him ingest it. So not that it matters. You can ingest it either if you can't get it into his mouth. It doesn't matter. I also got it for myself because I've got knee surgery and I'm stressed out of my brains trying to get all this sorted out. So there's going to be herbal supplements that you should probably have ready. One of them I recommend is my own product, as I mentioned before, is AC4. This is a really strong anti-inflammatory. It's all about reducing inflammation in the dog at the moment. And this is definitely one of the best ways to do it. So have that ready before he comes in. I do strongly recommend thinking about a product such as Calm and Mammy. This is from Holistic Hound. Based around valerian root. Valerian root is a really common natural sedative. That's, if you were to look up some of the tablets in any of the pet shops, the natural kind of relaxing tablets, they're all based on valerian root. You spray it around his crate and enclosure to relax him. It's also got lavender in there, oat seed, passion flower, and hops. Okay, so absolutely brilliant product. We use it when we're traveling with pups, dogs that are flying, they're being put under the planes, that kind of stuff. The equivalent would be DAP spray, dog appeasing pheromone spray, but I like the natural variety, really effective humans and dogs. So get a bit of that ready. There's also back rescue remedy. You know, dogs don't want to eat that too much, but you can drop it around their enclosure. Dogs are really sensitive through the nose, so you can drop that around. That's going to work just as effective, and you probably have that in your house already. So they're kind of your power additions you need to have ready, your supplements and bits. There's also power cubes we're going to be making. And for power cubes, you're going to be making bone broth mixed with golden turmeric paste. So to make bone, we're going to be putting them in this ice cube tray, mixing them together, put them in an ice cube tray. So you just have to pop them one a day, so there's no messing. To make bone broth, you are going to need gelatinous stuff with connective tissue on it. So I'd recommend picking up a bag of chicken feet or duck feet. You can buy them online from carnivorekellys.ie, or your butcher might have them. Pork trotters are brilliant for it. Any joint bones, okay, that's the stuff you want to put into your bone broth to to make the bone broth. So I'll show you how to do that in another video, but you do need to have that stuff ready. Don't be running around looking for this. Ideally, you would have this bone broth and golden turmeric paste made before the dog arrives back into your house. Like me, I haven't got it ready. So you need those ingredients ready to go. It's as simple as that. We're gonna slow cook that broth. The gelatin will rise to the top and we'll scrape it off and keep it in a pot. And that is brilliant for joints. And we're gonna make golden turmeric paste, which I said you need the turmeric and you need raw, organic, virgin coconut oil. Okay, so it's cold pressed, it's good quality stuff. That's your power cubes. Finally, the day comes home and you want to start booking your appointments. Okay, so just get on it. Get them into hydrotherapy and get them into physiotherapy. Find a good physiotherapist and a good hydrotherapist. So that's about it. I'm just going to recap through those main topics again. You want to remember you need to do your living area, the pieces that, with your pen and your crate. You need to get your prepare for your cleanliness, maybe some wipes, maybe some magic foam, the likes. You need some aloe vera for the wound. You need to get them on a fresh or raw diet. Go to my website, dogsfirst.ie, and you can go to the raw section. It teaches you how to move the dog onto a raw diet. Any raw diet would suit this dog at the moment, but I would recommend incorporating maybe 20-30% raw veg in there just to make sure that he has a nice soft poo, because his back function isn't going to be brilliant. You might get pick up some probiotics, have them in the fridge. Full fat probiotic yogurt, probably the best you'll do there. Your power additions, you might pick up some herbs, you might pick up some echinacea maybe for his health, or dandelion root or milk thistle for his liver to help him get him over all the meds that he's going to be on from your vets. You might pick up some natural supplements like AC4 or any kelp. Okay, this AC4 is a seaweed based product, or you got CBD oil, you need to pick that up. Maybe some arnica. That would be recommended, and maybe one of these tablet organizing trays, because by the time you come out of the vets with all those packets of tablets, you need to organize them. You want your power cubes, so you need an ice cube tray, your ingredients, your bone broth, your ingredients, your golden turmeric paste, and book your appointments. Okay. Lastly, you're probably going to need a bit of wine for yourself. Ideally, guys, get all that stuff in before the dog comes home. Don't be like me, where I'm running around buying these ingredients, I'm panicking about my dog at home. Crate, is he okay? Hope this helps you out. So we'll see you in the next video. Okay, thanks for listening. Bye-bye.